Hi everyone, today we are going to make a quiz using Google Forms. By the end of this video, you'll know how to add questions, change question types, see how the answers are graded, choose correct answers, and even analyze the results. Today's theme is Star Wars, so I hope you're ready to get geeky with me. There are three ways you can start a new Google Forms quiz. You can either start by going into your Google Drive and selecting the New menu, and then there will be a Forms icon right there for you to select. Or you could go to forms.google.com to get a new form that will be totally blank. But the easiest way to do it is to go to forms.new, which will immediately drop you into a new form. Here we are on a blank, untitled form in the Google Form app. The first thing I want to do is change the name of my quiz to something besides untitled form. I want to name this Star Wars quiz. We'll do that up in the top left, and you'll notice it populates here in the middle as well. Next, I will head over to Settings, where I will select the toggle Make This a Quiz. There are a few different settings that I want to talk about and highlight here today. The first one is this one called Release Grades. So what this means is that immediately after someone who's taking your quiz submits it, they will see the grade that they got. The next setting I want to highlight is one under Responses. Here I want to limit the responses to one. This means that people can't keep coming back and taking the quiz over and over. Next, I want to highlight one of the settings here under Presentation. I like to enable the progress bar because that way your quiz takers know how far along they are in the quiz, especially if you have a large quiz, maybe 30 questions, it's a big test. This way people know how much longer they have to spend on the quiz. And last but not least, I always include a confirmation message to let my quiz takers know that we have recorded their submission. And in this case, I'm going to say impressive, most impressive, and then I will hit save. There are many other settings you can configure, but for now, we are all set. Next, I'm going to move to the really important part of this quiz, the questions section. The first thing I want to do is add a form description or a description for the quiz. I will add a little bit of Star Wars humor in here and then start on my first question. Our first question is going to be, who built C-3PO? And next I'm going to start writing in some options. I'll write Leia here, and then I will put a number of other options for our quiz goers. Now that I've added in a number of possible answers, I need to tell Google Forms which is the correct answer for this quiz. And to do so, I will go down to the bottom left here and select answer key. Now, I hope those of you watching know the correct answer. For the truly geeky, you already know it is, in fact, Anakin Skywalker. So we will select that. A little green arrow appears. And if you consider this question easy, you might assign it 5 points. And if you consider it difficult, you might add 10 points. It's really up to the quiz creator to decide how many points each question is worth. If you want to have some fun with your quiz takers and get a little cheeky, you can actually add some answer feedback. Here you can add feedback for incorrect answers and correct answers. For incorrect answers, I'm going to have the following feedback. Curse your metal body, you weren't smart enough. I also want to include a link to Wikipedia so our quiz takers can learn a little more about C-3PO. I will hit add, and then for correct answers, I will paste in, you have done well. Now that I've added in feedback, I want to leave this answer key area by selecting done in the bottom right. So far, our quiz is only one question, and I want to add another one. To do so, I will go up here to this circle icon with the plus inside of it and click add question. Although multiple choice is the most common type of questions, Google Forms does provide a number of options such as paragraph and short answer. We're actually going to make our next question a short answer question. My next question is going to be, which famous character grew up on a planet destroyed by the Death Star? Next, we'll want to go and add answers in the answer key. First, we'll type in Leia, but people might actually type in Princess Leia. This is an interesting distinction, so you're telling Forms that either of these two answers are okay to use, and then here you can select this box to mark all other answers as incorrect. Once you've done that, you can change the point value. I'm going to set this to 10 and then click done. I don't feel like adding any more answer feedback for this question. I'll also want to ensure that this is a required question on my quiz, so I will toggle the slider here. If you want to alter the order of your questions, one of the nice features in Google Forms is you can grab them and move them around. The quiz is coming together nicely, but it's looking a little bland. I think I want to add some spice to it, some imagery maybe. Up here, you can actually use this paint icon to click Customize Theme. And here we have this nice option to choose an image to add to the header. I really like this. So there are some stock photos you can choose from, but I want to upload something that's very Star Wars related. Here we have one on our desktop. Say open. Next, it'll ask me to size it, and I want the words Star Wars in there. Then I'll click done on the bottom right. And there you have it, Star Wars header, beautifully displayed at the top of our quiz. You may have noticed that the entire coloring of the quiz has changed. Google does this really smart thing where they pull in all of the main colors from your image and set it as your theme. You could always choose to edit this or any of the fonts if you so choose to. In addition to headers, each question can have its own image or video. I think I'll add one here for the C-3PO option. One really interesting thing that Google does is it leverages some of its search capability, and you can look for an image of C-3PO and see what comes up. This looks good. I'll choose this one and insert it into the question. The image comes in quite large in the beginning, but with a slight resizing down, I think it'll fit this quiz nicely. Next, I'll want to know when people have taken my quiz. So to do that, I'm going to go to the Responses tab, and I'm going to click these three ellipses and say, get email notifications for new responses. Additionally, in here, you can select the destination for your responses. I want them to show up in a Google spreadsheet, and you can choose to target the answers to land on an existing spreadsheet you already have. Say, if you're a teacher and you're trying to do a quiz every quarter with a new class, but also if you just leave it blank, they will create a new one for you. So far, I have zero responses to my quiz, but I can see it has been enabled to accept responses, so the quiz is ready to rock. I think the quiz is coming together nicely, but before I choose to send it, I want to see what it'll look like when people actually receive the quiz. To do that, I'm going to use this preview icon up here. It's in the shape of an eye. I actually find this quiz to be quite professional looking. I like the color scheme. It's really, you know, taking the joy of Star Wars and putting it into this quiz, and I think people will have a good time with it. If I want to exit this preview mode, I'll just go down to the bottom right hand and click Edit This Form to take us back to the menu we were in previously. When I'm ready to publish or send the quiz out, I get to click this big rectangular send button up here, and Google has some neat options to send the quiz out. You can do the standard way via email, but you can also send it through a link. So if you want to send it over a group chat or something like that, and if this link seems a bit daunting, you can always shorten it. Additionally, you can choose to embed this on a website if you want your quiz to live longer, or you can send it over Facebook or Twitter. I want to share this quiz with some friends over a chat, so I will go down here, copy the link, and then close this out so we can see when the responses start to come in. And oh, look at that! Someone has already responded. I will move over to the Responses tab to see how they did. And one of the things I want to call out here is that you can look at the responses at a high level in the summary section. You can look at the average amount of points, the frequently missed questions, things like that. But you can also look at the individual level to see how your quiz takers did person by person. And you can also do some question analytics here as well. For even more in-depth analysis, you can click into the spreadsheet to see how people are responding and export this if you want to, or manipulate the data however you like. And there you have it, the simple, fun, and easy way to make a quiz using Google Forms. I'd love to hear how it went for you. Please share how it went in the comments down below, or just share your favorite Star Wars trivia or Star Wars quote. Please consider subscribing, and we will see you in the next video.